Let us solve a problem by applying Kirchhoff's voltage law. The question is, for the circuit shown, determine V2 using KVL, that is voltage across resistor R2 using KVL. Determine I. So I is also given here. So I is the current flowing through the circuit, which was also marked in the question. So determine I. And also determine resistors R1 and R3, value of resistors R1 and R3. Okay, so we have a circuit with three resistors R1, R2 and R3. Value of R2 is given as 7 ohm. We have to calculate R1 and R3. Then voltage across R1 is given, that is 18 volt. Voltage across R3 is given, that is 15 volt. And we have to calculate V2. So our first part is to calculate V2 using KVL. So apply KVL to this particular equation. So what are the step-by-step procedures for applying KVL to a particular loop? First of all, let us mark the current. We can mark the current in any direction. It can be either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So here the current is given in this particular direction. So now let us mark the polarity of voltages. So we know that current is flowing from a higher potential to a lower potential. So for R1, current is flowing in this direction, that is from this point to this point. So here there will be the higher potential and this is the lower potential point. So current flows from higher potential to lower potential. So here also current flows from higher potential to lower potential. And I flows like this. So from higher potential to lower potential. So now let us apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. So for applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, we need to trace the circuit in any particular direction. So let us trace the circuit in clockwise direction. So clockwise direction. So let us move from this point in the clockwise direction. So when I am moving like this, for this battery, we are moving from positive terminal to negative terminal. That is from a higher potential to a lower potential. So when we are moving from a higher potential to a lower potential, there is a drop in potential. So that should be marked with negative sign. So minus E. Battery voltage should be marked as minus E. So now next component is the resistor R3. So we are moving in this direction, that is from negative to positive. So there is a rise in potential. So battery voltage can be marked as positive. So plus V3. Now, when we are moving in this direction, the next component is resistor R2. And we are moving from negative to positive. So there is a rise in potential, so V2 can be marked as positive. So we are coming in this direction. So next component is R1. So we are moving from negative to positive. So there is again a rise in potential and V1 can be marked as positive. And according to Kirchhoff's voltage law, the algebraic sum of all the voltages in a closed mesh will be 0. Okay. So now we have to calculate V2. Determine V2. So what will be the value of V2? V2 will be equal to E minus V1 minus V3. So E is given as 54 volt. 54 minus V1 is 18 minus V3 is 15. The answer will be 21 volt. So we got the value of V2 as 21 volt. So first part is complete. Now second part is determine the current I. So we have to calculate the current flowing through this circuit. Okay. So we know the value of voltage across R2 and also the value of resistor R2. So for resistor R2, V and R are known. And according to Ohm's law, I, current flowing through a resistor, can be calculated as V by R. So we can calculate I as. So this is part A, in part B, we can calculate I as V2 divided by R2. So we got V2 as 21 volt divided by R2 is given as 7 ohm. So answer will be 3 ampere. So I will be 3 ampere. Now third part, we have to calculate the value of resistor R1 and resistor R3. So for R1, we know the value of voltage across it and also the current flowing through it. Voltage across R1 is 18, current flowing through it is I. We have calculated it as 3 ampere. So R will be V by I. R is equal to V by I. So R1 will be equal to V1 divided by I, which is equal to 18 divided by 3 is equal to 6 ohm. And R3, voltage across R3 is 15 volt. So V3 divided by I, which is equal to 15 divided by 3 is equal to 5 ohm. So we have calculated all the required parameters.